The cable car will take you down to the slums. It's the quickest route to the river. The truck should be on the other side. But Jane, come on, don't...
What the? Hey, Jakob. I think I found some of those mutated snaggletooth fuckers.
Yep. And now you're really seeing this planet. The war is the least of it.
Some writing here.
Thank you.
Hmm. A journal.
We're almost back to your camp.
Copy. How's Jane doing?
She's barely hanging on. I'm doing what I can, but she'll make it. She has to.
Thank you.
There's some notes here. What do we have here? There's some notes here. Zahidi, I'm crossing the bridge. Where can I find the truck?
There are old garages near the city gate. They probably would keep it there to protect against the anomaly.
Thank you. looks like some old reports.
Hey, Zahidi, I'm in. There's a lot of trucks in here. They all look the same.
I hid the briefcase under the truck's driver's side door. Just search them all!
Make me dig my own grave next.
This better be worth it.
Oh my God. It's still intact.
The satellite uplink.
The last satellite uplink.
So that's what you were looking for when you found me?
Yeah.
And it still works? How?
The case, it's mu metal. It insulates. It's never been opened, so the electronics inside have been safe from the goddamn anomaly.
So, what does it connect to? The Flores. I thought it was all disassembled for the colonization.
Mostly. But we lost contact towards the end. Half of the resources we were meant to have are still up there. They're trapped in the supply pods. Seeds, electronics, hard drives full of data, all out of reach. We could rebuild civilization with those resources, but they're useless to us unless we can find a place beyond the storms. I know, it might sound like a dream, but for those of us that believed, it kept us going.
So this is it. That's why Shira sent me to get you. She wants what's inside those pods. So, what do we do now?
Your frequency. I can use it to locate the source of the signal. I need to reach an antenna up high somewhere.
You got one in mind?
Yeah. Eagle Peaks. But, not yet.
I told you. Everyone who goes on this stupid mission ends up dead.
Only way to get some rest around here. Rest well, Jane.
It's good to get our best rolling.
Zahidi's truck is in bad condition. I've scavenged all the useful equipment. Doc will have to ride with us.
Must have been fascinating for you, Outrider, waking up in the future. If you ever find a moment, I would like to hear more about your fellow Outriders. I was just a kid when they were all rounded up and driven off.
Outrider, what can I do for you?
Tell me, Dr. Zahidi.
Careful. That's the very last satellite uplink on Enoch. You don't know how long it took me to find it.
How did you even know to look for it?
My father. I found reference to it in his notes. After we landed, he was out here looking for a signal. Long before we were. He was the first one to send expeditions. And back then, I was just a kid.
You came to Enoch as a child?
Hmm.
Not many kids were on board the Flores.
My father, being who he was, had the luxury of bringing his family.
Why didn't we know about the anomaly before we landed? I mean, surely it must have shown up on the surveys.
I assure you, this is not the world we were promised. Every report that came back to Earth told the same story. They had found the Garden of Eden, not some world that would be trying to kill us in every conceivable way. We would have stayed on Earth for that.
So what the fuck happened?
I don't know. My dad, he knew this planet backwards and forwards. He was on the science council that chose this world. Obviously, something happened during the 67 years we were asleep in hyperspace. Something changed this planet.
The anomaly. Can you explain it?
Well, short answer, no. They call it an anomaly because it can't be explained. It defies all known physics. It seems to be some fundamental force of this planet's nature, electromagnetic and gravitational. But it's also a kind of weather system that obeys rules and can even be forecast. Sometimes it shines, sometimes it rains. Mostly rains. I have theories, but the scientific method depends on observation, hypothesis, experimentation, and finally, peer review. The problem is, I have no peers left.
I'm wondering, is it possible there are other Outriders still in cryo?
Well, it's entirely possible. Jane and I, we weren't expecting to find your team, and with insurgents closing in, we didn't have time to look for anyone else. I don't have to tell you how dangerous the first city is, but I'd want to be the first to know what you find.
I'm curious too. I'll go check it out.
If you were to find other outriders had survived.
Found you and was in an old medical lab near the river. You should start searching.
Hey, Zahidi. Why did no one else think to wake the Outriders up for 30 years?
Well, after what happened to you in the forest, they told us they were trying to find a cure. But they never did.
But if there's no cure, How'd you know it wouldn't kill me when you opened my pod?
I didn't. I'm sorry. I was only concerned with finding the uplink.
Sure. Got it. Priorities. A journal. I found a transfer order that says ECA moved most of the cryopods to a different location. Some B2 facility.
I've got an old map here. Looks like B2 is the big pod across the bridge. Should be on your left.
What's the quickest way there?
Try following the city walls. They'll lead you close to the facility.
Some kind of writing. I'm inside. I'll look for the cryopods. I found Skarstedt.
What are you talking about? He's alive?
No. ECA turned him into a terrarium.
Oh, come on! Skarstedt? Damn it. I fought with that bastard in Baghdad and Caracas. He never gave up. He was supposed to end his tour of duty on his feet.
They all were. Zahidi, the ECA was experimenting on us. Did you know?
No, I didn't, I swear. But the Outriders were patience zero. It makes sense they would study you to save others.
And kill half of us off in the process? That is fucked up.